हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, लेट्स वेलकम टू मेक मैथ्स इजी विथ सुनंदा कदम चैनल। वी हैव स्टार्टेड लेसन नंबर 8, अल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशंस एंड ऑपरेशंस ऑन देम। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव एक्सप्लेन द मीनिंग ऑफ अल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशंस। देन यू हैव लर्न्ड व्हाट इज मीन बाय लाइक टर्म्स, अनलाइक टर्म्स। We can add or subtract only like terms. After that, we have seen types of algebraic expressions: monomial, single term; binomial, two terms are there; trinomial, three terms; and polynomial means more than three terms. These all things we have seen in previous video. Today we are going to start operations on algebraic expressions. In that, the first operation is addition of the algebraic expression. Let's see practice set 33, first example. What is the first example? It is given in horizontal arrangement. 9p plus 16q, this is the first expression, and we have to add 13p plus 2q. So let's arrange them vertically. While adding the algebraic equations, what important thing you have to remember? Like term should be in a straight line, one after another. 9p, downside of 9p, what to write? 13p. If you write 2q, we can't add. We can add only like term. This is the most important rule. We can add only like terms. So arrange the equations very properly. First write down 9p plus 16q. Downside of 9p, what will come? 13p plus 2q. So here I have written both the equations in vertical arrangement. 9p plus 16q plus 13p plus 2q. Now it's a very simple addition. You have to add the numbers and write the variable as it is in the addition. So 13 plus 9, 13 plus 9, 22, and p as it is, plus 16q plus 2q, 16 plus 2, 18. So 18q. This much simple. This is the first addition of algebraic expressions. Let's see the second problem. First I will read it. 2a plus 6b plus 8c. This is the first algebraic expression, and we have to add the second algebraic expression, that is 16a plus 13c plus 18b. How to arrange? First write down the first algebraic expression as it is, 2a plus 6b plus 8c. Now while arranging the second expression, what is important? See the like terms very carefully. So 2a, downside of 2a, what will come? 16a plus 6b. Downside of 6b, which term we want? Plus 18b. Don't write 13c because we can't add. We can add only like terms. So while arranging the terms, you should be very careful. 2a plus 16a, 6b, downside of 16b, what to write? 18b. So here I have written 18b. Then downside of 8c, you can write this 13c. So it is as easy to add the like terms. Now 16a plus 2a, add the number 16 plus 2, 18, and a as it is. Plus 18 plus 6, 24b, plus 13 plus 8, 21, see, finished. This much simple. Only add the numbers and write the variable as it is. Let's see the next problem, that is third one. First, it is given in horizontal arrangement. 13x square minus 12y square. This is the first algebraic expression. And add 6x square minus 8y square in it. First, write down 13x square minus 12y square plus 6x square minus 8y square. Here we are using the rules of signs. In addition or subtraction, when both numbers are negative, what is the rule? Here I will revise the rules of signs once again. When one number is positive and one is negative, which operation we have to do? Subtract them and give big number sign. This is the first rule of addition and subtraction. What is the second rule? When both numbers are negative, add them and give the same sign. Here which is the same sign? Negative, negative. So to the answer give the negative sign. Add the numbers and give the negative sign. So in this problem, we are going to use the second rule of rules of addition and subtraction. So first term, it is simple to add 13x square plus 6x square. As both are positive, it is very simple. Simply add them. 13 plus 6, 19x square. Look at the second terms. Here both numbers are negative. Negative 12, negative 8. Just now we have seen the rule. In addition or subtraction, when both numbers are negative, add them and give the same sign, means negative sign. So negative minus 12 minus 8 is minus 20, or negative 20. You can use both the words because the meaning is same. Understood the second rule of signs? When both numbers are negative, add them and give the same sign. Let's see the next example. Fourth one. First, I will read the problem. 17a square b square plus 16c. This is the first algebraic expression. And add in it 28c minus 28a square b square. Okay. So first, as usual, write down the first algebraic expression. What is that? 17a square b square plus 16c. Now look at the second algebraic expression. Here 28c, this is the first term, but where it will go? Downside of 16c, because we are add or subtract only like terms. And this negative 28a square b square will come here downside of 17a square b square. After arranging the expressions, then it is simple to solve. Again here rule is there. In addition or subtraction, look at this rule. When one number is positive and one number is negative, what we are doing? Subtraction. And giving sign of the big number. So see here. Here we are adding the algebraic expression. In that one number is positive and one number is negative. So what our rule says? Subtract the number. So 28 minus 17. What will come? 11. And which sign we have to give? Sign of the big number. Here big number is 28 and its sign is negative. So what will come here? Negative 11 a square b square. And here 16c plus 28c. Here both are positive. So positive. Do this addition. 8 plus 6, 14. 4 here. 1 goes carry. 2, 3 and 4. 44c. We are writing the variable as it is. Understood the second rule of Science. While solving these examples, we are revising the rules of science, and it is really very, very important in algebraic expression or while solving the problems of addition, subtraction, multiplication or division. Now let's move towards the fifth problem. First I will read it. 3y square minus 10y plus 16. This is the first algebraic expression. And second expression is 2y minus 7. Here only two terms, means it is a binomial. And in first expression, three terms, means it is a trinomial. So let's arrange vertically. 3y square minus 10y plus 16. Now here y square term is not there. So 2y, where this 2y will come? Downside of negative 10y plus 2y minus 7. So here downside of 3y square term is not there. So directly it will come as it is 3y square. Here again we are using rule of sign. When one is positive, one is negative, subtract them and give sign of the big number. So 10 minus 2, 8, and big number sign is negative. So negative 8y. Again the same rule. One is positive, one is negative. While adding or subtracting the numbers, when one is positive, one is negative, subtract them and give the sign of big number. So 16 minus 7, 9, and big number is positive. So positive 9. What is the answer? 3y square minus 8y plus 9. Look at the last example of practice set 33. First I will read it. Negative 3y square plus 10y minus 16. This is the first algebraic expression, and we have to add the second algebraic expression, that is 7y square plus 8. Here only two terms, so it is binomial. Here three terms, so it is trinomial. So as usual, first write down the first expression and then arrange the second expression by using the like terms formula. So downside of negative 3y square, what will come? 7y square. In the second expression, term of y is not there, directly number. So this positive 8 will come downside of negative 16. Now do the addition, and while adding, use the rules of the signs. So again, one is positive, one is negative. What the rule says? Subtract the numbers and give the sign of the big number. So 7 minus 3, 4, and big number is positive. So positive 4y square. When the number is positive, there is no need to write plus sign. Though we are not writing, it is always there. Plus 10y, here downside no term, so directly that 10y will come downside as it is. Now look at these two numbers. One is negative, one is positive. What is the rule? When one number is positive and one is negative, subtract them and give the sign of big number. So 16 minus 8, 8, and big number sign is negative. So negative 8. So what is the answer of this problem? 4y square plus 10y minus 8, or negative 8. Like this way we can solve the additions of the algebraic expressions. In the next video we will see subtraction of algebraic expression. Watch the video very carefully, and if you like the video, please give likes and share with your friends so that it is useful to them also. Thank you. Have a good day.